we can really begin to take a look at the emergence of the modern age with the enclosure movements of the great European commons in the 14th, 15th, and 16th century. Medieval life was a collectively lived life. It was a brutish, nasty affair, but there was a collective responsibility. People belonged to the land did not belong to people. And in this European world, people farmed the land in a collective way because they saw it as a commons. It belonged to God. And then it was administered by the church, the aristocracy, and then the local manors as stewards of God's creation. Beginning with Tudor England, we began to see a phenomenon emerge, and that is the enclosure of the great commons by parliamentary acts in England and then in Europe. And so first we began to take the great land masses of the world, which were commons and shared, and we reduced those to private property. Then we went after the oceans, the great oceanic commons, and we created laws and regulations that would allow countries to claim a certain amount of water outside their coastal limits for exploitation. In this century, we went after the air, and we divided it into air corridors that could be bought and sold for commercial traffic for airplanes. And then, of course, the rest is history.